Hidden in the misty wetlands of the Carolinas, a silent predator lurks, motionless, patient, and deadly. But this killer has no fangs, no claws, and no heartbeat. It's a plant. The Venus flytrap is one of nature's most bizarre creations, a green assassin that defies everything we expect from the plant kingdom. Thriving in one of the harshest environments for plant life, it found an extraordinary way to survive, by turning into a carnivore. But how does this plant trap and digest its prey? What evolutionary forces pushed it to seek meat over minerals? And how does this tiny botanical hunter challenge our very definition of what a plant can be? In this video, we'll journey into the strange and spectacular world of the Venus flytrap, uncovering its lightning fast trap, its survival tactics in nutrient-poor soil, and the evolutionary secrets that make it one of the most fascinating plants on Earth. The Venus flytrap, with a scientific name of Dionaea muscipula, thrives in the humid wetlands of North and South Carolina, where the air hangs heavy and the ground stays damp year-round. But despite the swamp's lush appearance, the soil here tells a different story. It's highly acidic and extremely poor in nutrients, especially nitrogen, which most plants rely on for growth. In such a harsh environment, most plant life struggles to survive. But the Venus flytrap found a solution unlike any other. It turned to hunting. Instead of relying solely on its roots to absorb nutrients from the poor soil, this remarkable plant evolved a radically different survival strategy. It hunts insects. With jaw-like leaves that snap shut with lightning speed, it catches and digests tiny creatures like flies, ants, beetles, and even spiders, all to supplement the nutrients the soil can't provide. While it still uses sunlight for energy through photosynthesis, in this nutrient-starved soil, sunlight alone isn't enough. So, the Venus flytrap became a part-time carnivore, relying on its deadly traps to get the missing pieces it needs to flourish. The Venus flytrap's most fascinating feature is its trap, an ingenious piece of anatomy designed for one purpose: to catch prey. Each trap is actually a modified leaf, shaped like a hinged, lobed structure, resembling a pair of jaws. These lobes are lined with sharp, spiky teeth-like projections, which act like prison bars to hold the prey in place once the trap is shut. On the inner surface of these lobes are 3 to 4 tiny hair-like structures known as the trigger hair, which serve as the plant's sensors. When an insect or small animal touches 2 of these trigger hairs within a span of 20 seconds, it activates a complex physiological process. The plant reacts by quickly closing the trap. This happens in less than a second, a rapid movement for a plant, and almost instantaneous by any standard. This speed ensures that the Venus flytrap only captures real prey, avoiding unnecessary traps for things like raindrops or falling leaves. So, how does a plant move so fast without muscles? It all comes down to turgor pressure, the water pressure inside the cells of the trap. When the trigger hairs are touched, the Venus flytrap releases water from the cells in the lobes of the trap. This sudden change in water pressure causes the cells to lose rigidity and collapse, essentially forcing the lobes shut with a speed and force that is like a hydraulic system in action. The snapping movement is so quick that it almost seems mechanical. Although the Venus flytrap doesn't have nerves like animals, it generates electrical signals when the trigger hairs are touched. These signals travel through the plant, similar to how nerve impulses work in animals. Once the Venus flytrap snaps shut, it turns into a leafy stomach, getting ready to digest its meal. Inside the trap, the plant releases digestive enzymes that begin the process of turning the insect into a source of nutrients. These enzymes are breaking down the soft parts of the prey, such as muscle tissue, so the plant can absorb the good stuff. The whole process can take anywhere from 5 to 12 days, depending on how big the meal is. It's an incredibly slow but efficient digestive system, one that allows the Venus flytrap to gain crucial nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus, which are scarce in the swampy, nutrient-poor soil it calls home. The thing is, Venus flytrap doesn't actually eat to fuel itself. Photosynthesis is still its primary source of energy, just like any other plant. The insects are merely a nutrient boost, supplying missing elements that the soil can't provide. After digestion, the trap reopens, revealing an empty, clean chamber, ready to trap again for its next unlucky victim. As for the leftovers, the plant doesn't bother with them. The tough, crunchy exoskeletons of the insects remain behind, but the Venus flytrap doesn't need to clean up. Over time, rain washes away the debris, or the wind blows it away, leaving the trap free of waste and primed for the next hunt. Surviving in the wild isn't easy, even for the remarkable Venus flytrap. While its ability to catch prey is impressive, it doesn't always get it right. Sometimes the traps snap shut on nothing at all, wasting precious energy. Each trap can only close a few times before it weakens and eventually dies. So the Venus flytrap must be careful with every trap it uses. If you have one as a houseplant, treat it with care. Don't feed it human food like hamburger. It's a true carnivore, but only hunts small, live insects such as flies, ants, or spiders. Too much feeding or the wrong kind of food can harm the plant. Sadly, the Venus flytrap is listed as vulnerable due to threats like habitat destruction and illegal poaching, with many plants being dug up and sold as exotic houseplants, endangering their survival in the wild. The Venus flytrap is more than just an oddity of nature. It's a powerful reminder of how life can adapt in the most unexpected ways. As one of the few plants that actively hunts to survive, it challenges our traditional views of plant behavior, blurring the line between plant and predator. Its unique ability to thrive in nutrient-poor soil by relying on insects for essential nutrients is a testament to the ingenuity of evolution. The Venus flytrap not only showcases nature's creativity, but also serves as a reminder of the importance of protecting biodiversity. Every species, no matter how unusual, plays a vital role in its ecosystem, and the Venus flytrap is no exception. Thanks for exploring the incredible biology of the Venus flytrap with us. If you enjoyed exploring interesting stories with us, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. What topics do you want us to dive into next? Let us know in the comments. Join us as we get animated about science here at Animated Science.